The thing I love about being back in Pennsylvania is I don't have to explain me. You peckerheads, I mean in a nice way. You know who I am and you know where I come from. I gotta spend 20 minutes on any stage outside of Pennsylvania explaining me. Are you really Amish? No, I thought it would be fun to just walk around in society for 30 years looking like this. And driving instead of flying all the way to fuck from Pennsylvania through Savannah in record-setting heat in a black suit to come down here and perform for old people that can't even see me. And they could have seen me in Pennsylvania, but they know they thought it would be more fun for me to wait till they get really old so they retire and I could just drive there instead of them coming to the fucking casino here in Wilkes-Barre where they can see me. And just drive, short drive from Pittston, wherever the hell it is. And no. I thought, in 25 years, yeah, I'll fool them all. They'll think I'm a farmer. How do you leave the Amish? Well, you don't need that grand of a scheme. You don't have to tunnel out. You don't run to McDonald's and yell like effect. I just walked. I found a spot way over there where there were no Amish, and I just walked away from them. To this day, it torments me to madness that it took 18 years off my life to figure out that little escape route. I'm plowing the field, busting my balls off. No cold beer in the fridge, no fridge in the fridge. Person, please, give me a sign. How can I get out of here? Just one night with cable and air conditioning and cold beer. What should I do? Oh, that's brilliant. Kind of pulled off a kind of a dick move because I'm a high-tech Amish, I got an iPhone. I myself was running around like they're taking pictures of the Amish. It's really fun. I didn't know how much fun it was. I'm sending apology letters to tourists for 10 years now and I thought it was so mean to them. It's so much fun. As you peckerheads, you gotta kind of like sneak up to them and then get in position for a selfie. But not me. I'm Amish undercover. I can just like stroll in. Yo, soul food, and then like 19 of them turn around and say, yo, what up, bitch? Snapchat. That's the problem with the missing Amish guy in Lancaster. You can't put our face on the side of a milk carton. A couple problems with that. We can't have our face on the side of anything. And we don't use a milk carton. We get that shit right out of the spigot. Best case scenario. You get a cow and put a sign on it, and the sign would say you'd slap in the ass and walk around town, and people would read the sign, and it would say, if you've seen anyone that looks like me or you, but they're not here, tell them to go home. When shit goes wrong in our lives, we tend to blame our women, even if they had nothing to do with it. Edna, my honey, was clearly not on the other side of that counter when them assholes put mustard on my cheeseburger. She would take the brunt of my rage when I've been into that shit at home. Son of a bitch, this is all your fault. I got you, since you take it in the parking lot, you said, oh no, they're afraid of the werewolf. They know you don't like mustard. You, and that cocksucker, you're probably in cahoots while you send him a text message. Yeah, it worked. He's been into it. He's really pissed off. There he comes. You want to lock the doors and film it. It's going to go viral on the YouTube. LOL. I'm sorry we do that, ladies, but that's what we do, and I will take it back, and I have a pill left, but I don't want to calm down. I don't want to calm down. I want some satisfaction, an apology, and one of those little chocolate desserts that gives you diarrhea so I won't eat it. I'm just going to pitch it in the trash, but it's the idea. And I go in there, and they blame us every single time, and they blame you, and the roughest, toughest, biggest sons of bitches down here, we take it like a bunch of candy-ass pussies. You go in there all mad and go, there's mustard on my cheeseburger. And then they do like this hypnosis shit on you. And you watch, when the head tilts, that's when you're going to get it. And go, well, did you order it with mustard? And it works every time. Here's the thing, I hate mustard, but I'm also mildly retarded. And I suffer from multiple personality disorder, and what might have happened was the well-adjusted me under the proper medication drove us here, and then my pill wore off, and at the moment of order, the evil Lord Voldemort, he who shall not be named me, said, why don't you put mustard upon his cheeseburger? If you have a long-term settlement, but you need cash now, call J.G. Whitford, 877-CASH-NOW. I have an annuity, but I need cash now, call J.G. Whitford, 877-CASH-NOW. I'll take you from the bridge. They tell thousands and help you too. One lump sum of cash is what they'll give to you. I have in my iPod, I used to shovel snow to an 877-CASH-NOW. There's one I hate that everybody thinks I like, but it gives me nightmare flashbacks. We are farmers. They can see me. The city guy's man, especially the Pennsylvania man, they have this whole list of shit that they think will make them gay. You can't love a cat, because that'll make you gay. You can't drink red wine, because that'll make you gay. Can't see a Broadway show, because that'll make you gay. If your sexuality is skating on that fine ice, you might as well take a bus trip up to New York, see Wicked on the way home, adopt a cat, grab yourself a bottle of Pinot Grease, and start sucking dick, because you're gay. Sorry, buddy, I don't want to blow you, but I pet a cat and I drank some wine, and it's all musical, though. Netflix knows me and suggests shit for me to watch based on what I've already seen, and I don't even question their wisdom. I just spoon feed whatever they think is good for me, and they explain it too, so there's no questions. Because you like Pee Wee's Playhouse and The Honeymooners, we thought you'd also enjoy Schindler's List and Brokeback Mountain, alright?